Okay, John, for your present track, you've gone for the choral, Dreaming of You.
Yeah.
What is it about that particular track?
I think it was one of the first singles, and there's a bit, there's the middle eight bit or the chorus bit that it just gets me every time, In My Lonely Room bit. I just love the way he sings that. It's just a fantastic little, jaunty little song. From this pain I just can't disguise. It's gonna hurt, but I'll have to say goodbye. I went to see them live and they were so young and so talented, they made me want to stop being in a band, which is a bad thing. I was watching the guitarist, who must have been about 16, thinking, well, I've been playing guitar since I was 11 and I can't do that, so what's the point, you know? But that's not why I like them, because that's quite depressing. I just think they're a brilliant band.
What gigs have you been to recently that sort of captured your imagination?
It was the UK Music Hall of Fame that I inducted New Order into the UK Hall of Fame, which is a lovely honour.
You played Bernard Sumner from New Order in 24 Hour Party People.
Yeah.
Did you know him at the time?
I didn't know. I didn't know him. I'd never met him, which was quite good actually for me, because I didn't want to do like an impression of him, you know? So I studied videos and a lot of interview footage. And I thought I told you to leave me. When I first saw the film, when we had a screening, he was sat right behind me, which was quite nerve-wracking. But he was lovely, and all I wanted at the end was his acknowledgement that it was okay, and he gave it to me. He was lovely. He's a lovely guy.
Who was rock and roll in 2006? Is there anyone that is living up to those dizzy heights of the 90s these days? Pete Doherty.
I'm not a big fan. I just don't. I don't quite get how he's suddenly become an icon, and he hasn't done enough to earn it. I don't think. I don't think he's done enough to earn it. Simple as that. I mean, the Libertines were good, but I mean, just what's cool about not turning up to gigs and being a smackhead? I don't get it. Maybe I'm just getting old.
We've moved location. I believe this is your manor, around here?
Yeah. So around the Muswell Hill way.
You've been in London since you were 18.
Yeah.
Have you lived a lot of your life in one area?
I've always been in North London because that's where the drama school was.
How did becoming a father change your life?
Oh, just totally and completely in every single way. I guess the first thing, you're not number one anymore, and that's weird, it takes some getting used to. And it's just it's a responsibility, basically, in a word, responsibility, and it's a good thing.
Did you stop the partying when he turned up?
I stopped the intensity of the partying.
Yes.
Yeah, but not totally. You know, I'm not 70.
I'm going to take you into your future track now. You have gone for what is it, John?
Absentee. And the song's called Something to Bang. It's kind of a cross between the Velvet Underground and Teardrop Explodes. You know, it's a great song. I'm tired of being a man. There's always something to bang. You're working up a sweat. You bring out the worst in me. I'll watch you drop off a dress. All pretty layers of fabric caress. Eyes wanting up your chest. It's bringing out the best in you.
What is it about this that attracted you to pick it as your future track?
It was just, as soon as it started, the first few bars got me. You know, I love the Velvet Underground, you know? It's kind of Waiting for the Man with a horn section. And the guy, he sounds a bit like Nick Cave. It's a good song. I don't know whether they're going to be huge or what. Maybe they will, but I just love this song. And I think on the balance of this, they should be quite successful.
So from 70s lad to 90s party boy, John Simm is now as serious about being a dad as he is about his music and acting career. Still to come on the Orange Playlist, he will dedicate a track to someone special, plus give us his all-time favourite song.
I find it quite difficult, just because I'm shy, really. If you took it away from me, I'd probably miss it. Every time I watch it, you know, it makes me cry.
It's life. Now it's time for him to reveal the song he'd dedicate to someone special, plus give us his all-time favourite track.
Every time I watch it, you know, it makes me cry. It's really scary and quite lonely and just a bit grim. If you took it away from me, I'd probably miss it.
I want to take you to one of your most recent things that we've seen you on, which was hugely successful, Life on Mars. Was it good fun?
Yeah, it's great being a 70s cop. Yeah, it's one of those things, a perk. It was great. Yeah, it was good fun.
Cypher. 7-0 to 0-1. That's stabbing at the bookies. Suspects have cornered in at Winton Drive.
Got to give it up. What else are they going to do? With the Force.
And may the Force be with you.
Did you take any sort of, like, reference from that? Because it was the 70s. Yeah. Was there anyone you based your character on?
I did look at a lot of DVDs of the Sweeney because they were hanging around and I couldn't really resist it, so I watched them again. And it held up surprisingly well.
Weren't you a big fan of The Professionals?
Yeah, I love The Professionals. I love The Professionals. If it's based on anything, I mean, the look of the character, Sam, I guess was Bodie, the way that he looked. Simply because he had short hair, and I was thinking, who had short hair that I can sort of look like? And Bodie had short hair.
You quite shun the celebrity lifestyle, don't you? How do you manage to keep the two separate?
I don't think I'm particularly famous, but from whatever level of fame that I've got, I find it quite difficult, just because I'm shy, really. And, you know, it's difficult when people plonk their pints down and sit down next to you and you kind of think, wait a minute, I don't know you. I don't know you, you know. I stay in, and that's the best way to sort of keep out of trouble and sort of, you know, keep away from it.
Does it quite scare you, the fame aspect of your job, or do you just find it a bit distasteful?
It just comes with the job, and it was not anything that I ever prepared myself for or thought about, really. It just happened. And I guess if you took it away from me, I mean, this is the paradox of it, if you took it away from me, I'd probably miss it. Yeah. If nobody knew who I was, I'd be thinking, hang on a minute.
We always ask people who come on the show to dedicate a song to someone special and yeah. Who it is in their life. And what is the song, please?
The song is Elvis Presley, Heartbreak Hotel.
Who have you dedicated this song to, John?
Dedicated it to my dad.
Why?
Well, because the show's about music, and I guess he's the biggest influence of my life with music. I mean, he taught me the guitar, he put me on stage, you know, I guess it's all thanks to him, really. If I hadn't been on stage, I don't think I probably would have been an actor, really.
Is your dad a big Elvis fan?
Yeah. We both agree that he's the king, you know, he's the best. Well,